bring by a little breakfast, hear all about the first day of school jitters. That's assuming she actually went to school this time.
Well, Bianca's fine. I'm a wreck. How did she get settled in over there okay? I wouldn't know. Bianca wouldn't allow me to do anything more than just drop her off at the curb.
Yeah, teenagers are like that.
Well, I was hoping to meet a guidance counselor. I just want everything to be perfect for Bianca.
I know. Spoken like a true mother.
Not overprotective?
Not at all, no.
Well, what if she hates it?
And skipped school to panhandle at the mall with her pal Snow?
The girl's name is Rain.
Oh, Rain. So sorry. Listen, Erica, Bianca's gonna be fine.
Opal, she's starting late. She doesn't know anyone. She's shy. I mean, it's hard enough to be a teenager.
Yeah, almost as hard as being a teenager's mama. Now, what is this you got going up here? Is this more of Bianca's stuff from Seattle?
No, it's mine. I thought maybe if I went through all this stuff, it would remind me of what it's like to be Bianca's age.
Well, I guess that sure beats reading her journal, huh? You didn't, did you?
I respect Bianca's privacy.
Yeah, well, I found you drooling over that journal. Did you read it?
Opal, if Petey had been through a very, very difficult time, and he was acting strangely and withdrawn, and he was fighting you on every single word that came out of your mouth, but you didn't know why, wouldn't you be desperate to find out what was wrong, and wouldn't you do anything you could to help him?
Oh, Erica, you did, didn't you? You read that journal.
You are taking a heavy load, but from what I saw of your transcripts, you're not going to have any trouble catching up.
I hope not.
I've notified your teachers to expect you because I want your transition to be as smooth as possible. So here's your schedule of classes and an orientation packet.
Oh, thanks, Miss Singer.
Bianca, I know you recently lost your father. If you ever want to talk about anything, I hope you'll feel free to come talk to me.
I think I'll be just fine.
Sure you will. Here's your locker combination. I'm sure you're not going to have any trouble finding it.
Thanks.
My door's always open.
13. Good thing I'm not superstitious. Need a mirror.
Everyone has one.
So what do you think so far?
Wow, it's something.
Wait until the pep rally on Friday. We'll introduce you to all the football players.
Only the honeys. Of course, they usually stick to dating cheerleaders.
It's too late for you to be a cheerleader, but tryouts for the pom-pom squad are coming up this basketball season.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah.
Pom-poms?
Yeah. You can try out with me. I would have made cheerleader, but it was a political thing.
Get over it, Mindy. Anyway, if you can't be a cheerleader, pom-pom girl is the next best thing.
You might have a shot. If you make it, you'll be among the most wanted.
Great. I'll take care of these.
Can't wait to be on the varsity team.
With your offense, you'll be varsity next year, no sweat.
Think so?
No, Marcus. So, good luck.
Who's the babe?
Oh, you want to meet her?
You know her?
Yeah.
Well, let's do it.
All right.
Hey, Marcus.
How you doing, Shannon? Who's your friend?
You are such a Mac. Don't gobble her up on the first day.
Hi, Bianca.
Hi, Junior.
This is my friend Marcus. He's the captain of the varsity soccer team.
They are totally awesome.
Marcus is the top scorer.
On and off the field.
God!
I'll remember that.
Well, I gotta go. If I'm late to science class, I'm busted.
See you, Marcus.
Bye, Bianca.
I should get going, too. I have to find my English class.
Really? Who's your teacher?
Mr. Kepler.
Looks like we're in the same class. I'll take you. Come on.
Oh, cool. I'll catch up with you girls later.
Whatever.
Well, whatever happened to respecting Bianca's privacy?
Some things are more important than privacy.
Yeah, what about Bianca's trust? Honey, if she ever finds out that you read her most secret thoughts, she will never speak to you again.
Well, that's a risk I'm willing to take. And you would, too. I know you would.
No, I would not. Part of being a parent is knowing when to leave well enough alone.
I tried that approach.
Yeah, and it didn't work because I interrupted you. Now, how much did you read?
Enough to know that something happened that traumatized her in rehab. What I read really scared me, Opal. Listen.
What?
She ripped out half the pages in her journal. What is Bianca hiding?
Well, what?
Well, nothing. She ripped out that whole section of her journal.
Well, I can't say that I blame her. You know, rehabilitation is a very deeply personal thing. I can't blame her for protecting her feelings.
You know, Opal, I've been there. I'm aware of that.
Yeah, well, then you of all people ought to be able to understand that writing in a journal is part of your recovery. Now, she fought her way back from a nightmare, honey, and she survived. Isn't that enough?
Opal. Something happened to Bianca that has nothing to do with her treatment, and she's still struggling with it.
Well, like what? Are you sure you're not just overreacting to plain old growing pains?
Oh, I wish. How I wish I could believe that. But it was in here, Opal. Bianca wrote about it. She wrote that she was so frightened, something so horrible happened to her, that she couldn't even find the words to describe it, and that she was going to have to face it before she could face the rest of her life.
Well, she was in a protected environment, honey. What could have happened?
Everything was fine, she said, until she went into that new therapy group. And then something happened. Something really traumatic. Opal, look, I'm worried that maybe she had her heart broken, but what if it was something more?
More like what?
What if she was molested? Or worse.
Now, honey, you don't know anything. You have no facts for that.
Oh, well, I was raped at 14. What if Bianca is going through that same thing right now?
Sweetheart.
I was lucky. I talked to my mother, and my mother was able to help me. Bianca has got to know that she can confide in me that way, no matter what.
Erica, where are you going?
I have got to go to Bianca. She's got to know that whatever this is she's going through, she's not going through it alone.
Totally,
it's so horrible.
You studied all night.
I know.
Hey, a babe with a brain.
Oh, not really.
Old Kepler, he asked a question about some book by Charles Dickens. Bianca was the only one who knew the answer.
It was no big deal. I took a Dickens survey course last year.
Hey, maybe we could study together, help each other with papers. I can type real fast.
You know what? It was just luck. I'm no egghead.
What's the deal, Marcus? You're jacking on Erica Kane's daughter.
The Erica Kane?
The one and only.
You may think that I'm interfering, but Bianca's been having a very difficult time, and I just want to be sure that she's all right.
We could use more parents who are actively involved in their children's lives.
Well, my daughter may not agree with you.
Oh, Bianca's very lucky to have such a concerned mother. If you step this way with her.
Mom, what are you doing here? I thought.